So we all know making resolutions is one thing, but actually sticking to them is another. And of course, it's usually a much harder deal.
Oh, yes. Luckily, there are plenty of websites and apps out there with the main goal of helping make the task as painless as possible. So joining us now to tell us about resolution apps is our tech expert, Nika Allen. Thank goodness we need your help.
Yeah. Good morning. Happy New Year.
Good morning.
Glad you're here as well. All right. So let's start with probably one of the most popular resolutions has to do with fitness, wellness. A lot of gym memberships going to be started today. So there is an app that's going to help us with our fitness and wellness. Is that right?
There certainly is.
Of course.
And I think that we should all do this together.
Oh. Okay.
So this is an app.
Down the gauntlet.
Yeah. This is an app called Lose It.
Okay.
And it helps you to set a daily calorie budget for yourself, track your food intake, and generally make smarter choices and, you know, help you track your exercise and stuff like that.
Okay.
I have been using this app and I honestly love it. It has a huge database of foods that are already in it. So you can look things up to record them. So you can say today I ate eggs, or the coolest part about it is you can actually scan barcodes in.
That's
so it
awesome.
Enters in all the information for you.
And you have the exact food that you're eating.
Exactly.
Sometimes, you know, different foods, different products will have different calorie count.
Yep, but with the barcode, it knows everything, you know, for you, so you don't have to do that manual entry.
That's incredible.
Yeah.
That's great.
And then you can also put your exercise habits in. And so for me, I wanted to try to lose 10 pounds. And so it told me, you know, add in your weight, your size, everything like that, your height. And then it was able to tell me approximately how many calories I should be eating a day. Yeah. And then she gives me charts and graphs so I can follow myself and also pair it with my friends. So my friends can watch
so
me do this.
So this is one
too.
That you can be with friends so they can keep you accountable?
Yes.
Okay.
That's, I think, one of the most important things about resolutions in general is kind of sharing them with as many people as possible so you can all hold each other accountable.
Yeah.
So this app makes it really easy for you to share with one another, and so you can't really hide and
fudge
things.
Keep it a secret.
Exactly, because that makes it easy. That makes it really easy.
Exactly. Okay, now how about an app to help with financial things? We just talked about this with Monica. It is a big resolution. A ton of people have this. So there's an app to help us, obviously, right?
There is. My favorite, and also everything that I'm talking about today is actually both a web platform and has a mobile app.
Okay.
So
oh,
you
great.
Can use it in multiple ways. So this is Mint, which I love. It's been my favorite financial and money management tool for actually a while. But it really helps you put all of your personal financial accounts and investments in one place.
Okay.
So you can track your spending habits, saving, you can make budgets, and you can even set goals for yourself. So one thing, it really has pretty much everything that comes, you know, for financial management. You can see here, there's tons of stuff
going on. Topher just started using this.
Really?
Yeah.
And does he like it?
Yes, he really does, because you can narrow it down into different categories. And you can see what you're spending money on. For us, it's food.
Yeah, so you can say food and rent, and you can put your, you know, different bills in there. And then I can say, well, this month I'll have X amount of money to go shopping with. So you can see that.
Oh, yeah.
One of my favorite parts of this app is I actually set it for one of my resolutions this year is hopefully to save enough money so I can go on a trip to Thailand.
Oh, very cool.
Okay. So I put specific amounts of money. I said, I want to go to Thailand. This is the price. They helped me. I put a travel. So then it helped me airfare, hotel, activities, things like that. It kind of helped me break it up.
Okay.
And I was able to put in estimates for how much I thought each day would cost me. And then it came up with a total for the amount that I need to save. And then it helped me figure out how much I needed to save for the time that I wanted to go.
Oh,
that's great.
So that's perfect
that
for
really
all
smart.
Of your resolutions. If you want a new car, if you're trying to save for a house, things like that, you can set all of that right in here. And it connects to a specific account, bank account of yours. So you can it can really hold you accountable. They can say, you know, well, you were able to save this amount of money and in this account. So you can do things like that.
Yeah, that's fantastic. That's cool. All right. And of course, you know, one that I actually think that I should make a resolution is to stay in better contact with friends, family, and things like that. And there is an app that helps with that as well, right?
Yes. There's an app called Lyft, which kind of actually can help you with any of your resolutions this year. It's a little bit more general. But just as we were saying, it kind of holds you accountable with other people. They have a whole community of Lyft users that you can kind of join big things like yoga or calling my mom and dad. And you can put that into and join a community of people who also are trying to do that. And then you can kind of give each other props.
It's like a support group.
Yeah, it's kind of like a support group to help you.
I know.
But yeah, I mean, it's hard
in the best way possible.
Yeah, things like that. But you can keep them to yourselves. You can keep them private, or you can Share them with other people. So, okay. And then your phone can give you reminders, did you drink water today? Mm-hmm. Did you call your mom today? Mm-hmm. And you can set it for certain times, mm-hmm. certain days of the week, things like that. Like every Sunday, I want to try to call my mom and mm-hmm. I'm going to have a reminder set on my phone. And then when I'm done calling my mom, I'm going to click, yes, that
you
I completed
that. Off.
Yes,
exactly.
I called my
checked
mom.
It off.
Get off my back phone.
I love checklists off. Yeah.
Exactly. I think that's a lot great. Of people like doing things. That. And yeah. it's a lot of fun to just be like, yes, I did that. Uh-huh. I got my goal, completed. And so this is a great way to do that and to have it something that keeps up every week. And you have a community of people that can do it. I connected that with my Facebook. And so I get to see what other people are trying to do, which was kind of cool because I was like, oh, I had no idea this person wants to be more outgoing, something like that, some interesting goals. And then,
that's
so
very cool.
Yeah,
it's great.
Plugged in and saw that.
So, and of course, last question for you, Nika. What is your big resolution for the year?
I am going to be one of those people that says, I want to eat healthier and work out more. I'm going to say
it's a good one.
There's a reason that it's so popular. Exactly. And so that's why I really want to use this app more to help me.
And we'll jump on there so we can
be friends. We can all be friends on there and we can watch each other's eating habits. And I'll be like, you know what? Don't eat McDonald's.
I know. See? That's what I mean. I need to get a time.
Being held accountable. That's right. Well, Nika, thank you so much. Again, Happy New Year. And for more information on what is going on this year and the latest trends for your New Year's resolutions, head over to Casa.com. We'll have links to Nika TV. Mm-hmm. All